let's roll. All right. This one is by futurism.com. Okay. And recently we had a whole bunch of hacks, right? Like, so I'm not sure if Google actually had a hack, but they went down just a few days back. They were down for like an hour or something like that. And like most of their services, and they said it was like a faulty something or other. Like they had a problem, right? And they claimed it was their problem, not like an outside hack. So whatever it actually happened to be, here's where we're at today with this. So this is futurism.com and another hack. December 18th, this is a hacker's likely linked to Russia have breached a number of federal agencies, right? So we do this. We talked about this a couple days back, but this is a new detail, including those responsible for the U.S. nuclear weapon stockpile. The recent attack on the National Nuclear Security Administration and the U.S. Department of Energy. So we knew it was the Department of Energy, but they didn't tell us a couple days back that it was the National Nuclear Security Administration that had been hacked as well. So this seems to be part of a larger ongoing attempt to hack critical U.S. infrastructure, according to The Independent. While the hack, which experts say is among the worst in American history, was only partially successful, it lays bare some critical flaws in American cybersecurity and represents a complex development for the country's already fraught relationship with Russia. So I guess this is Russia. Is that what we're saying? That's the implication, that it's Russia so far? Well, I guess we'll find out. Nick of time. Officials say that the hackers gained worrisome levels of access to the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, but that the nuclear stockpile itself remains secure. Well, isn't that a good thing? At this point, the investigation has found that the malware has been isolated to business networks only and has not impacted the mission essential national security function of the department, including the National Nuclear Security Administration, DOE spokesperson Shaylin Hines told The Independent. When DOE identified vulnerable software, immediate action was taken to mitigate the risk, and all software identified as being vulnerable to this attack was disconnected from the DOE network, Hines said. So, experts haven't yet been able to definitely prove that the hack originated in Russia, but the signs certainly point that way. As a result, The Independent reports that officials are stunned that outgoing President Trump hasn't commented on the attack, though President-elect Joe Biden had thoughts. Oh, nice. Nice. See what we're doing here? This is futurism.com. We gotta sling in some Orange Man bad for just a minute. And not like we haven't stuck the Russian connection, right? We have on the way out the door, we got to stick the Russian connection just a little bit more with Donald Trump. So let's see what Biden had to say. Quote, I want to be clear. My administration will make cybersecurity a top priority at every level of government, Biden said in a statement, and we will make dealing with this breach a top priority from the moment we take office. Okay. All right. Still campaigning, I guess. Oh, boy. Okay. So notably, that's the thing that's different, is we have the National Nuclear Security Administration was hacked, and by a foreign state actor of some sort, they say possibly Russia. And Trump actually did comment on this. I didn't pull up the tweet to talk about it, but I saw it was yesterday. And he said that it's possible that it was Russia, but he said there's also a possibility it could be China. And his implication when it was that it was China doing it, and it made it possibly look like Russia was responsible. So again, right, when you're doing like state level actions and hacks like this, of course you want to try and cover your tracks as much as possible. So you would expect that everybody that's hacking is trying to make it look like somebody else, right? I think that's the thing. So who knows? I guess the investigation is still ongoing, but this is a huge deal. This is into our nuclear federal agency.